If you have a business page on Facebook that you use to spread the word about who you are and what you do, or you advertise on Facebook, Facebook recommends setting up a Facebook business manager as good business practice that aids in adding to the legitimacy of your business. In this video, we'll go over why you might want to set up a business manager account, how to actually get one set up and get around inside it, how to bring your business page into your business manager and create an ad account. Let's do this. Welcome to How to Set Up Your Facebook Business Manager and Create a Facebook Ad Account. This video didn't really fit in with the last video, video 11, How to Set Up Key Social Media Profiles for Your Business, so I thought I'd make a standalone video and consider it part 2 of video 11. This video is part of a video series titled How to Easily Create a Web Presence for Your Business, Even If You Have Zero Technical Skills. I'm Kevin Stryker with TRU LIFT Digital Marketing. Let's get right at it. In the last video, we created social profiles, pages, and a channel for your business in Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Google+. Staying within the Facebook platform for this video, what I wanted to highlight from the last video was that I showed you how to create a personal Facebook profile for those that might not already have one, because it is a prerequisite for creating a Facebook page for your business, which we did in that video together. Having a personal profile is also a prerequisite for what we're going to be doing in this video, creating a Facebook business manager account. So if you didn't get a chance to watch part 1 of video 11, I suggest you go back and check that video out first. While you can create a business page directly inside a Facebook Business Manager, I will not be covering that here in part 2 as I already covered it in part 1. Facebook Business Manager is a central hub where you can manage your advertising accounts, your business pages, and access of various people within your business or outside your business relating to business activities within Facebook. It is not something that you necessarily need to set up in order to advertise or have a business page. So to explain who does need or should set up a Facebook Business Manager account, let's jump to the live screen. To do that, I'll start off inside of a fresh new tab with the Google search screen open. I'm just going to directly enter the URL that I want, which is business.facebook.com, and click enter. Which brings me to the Facebook for Business page. Now I already have a business manager set up, so I won't create a new one, but rather put my TRU LIFT digital marketing page inside of that existing business manager, but I'll show you how to set yours up. First, if you are wondering why you would even want to set one up, just scroll below. If your business is one where you require more than one ad account, or if perhaps you want the business manager to handle more than one business, that is a good reason. If you run an agency or have an agency that works for you and you want to give access to your account to them, the business manager can help you do that. If you have a staff or at least more than one person who you are going to give access to your Facebook account, but you want to control permissions to your pages or ad accounts, that is another solid reason. Maybe you've got someone who handles your advertising and a social media manager that handles the content on your pages, or if you just have a business partner, etc. And while it doesn't say so on this page, I've seen it elsewhere inside of Facebook support pages that creating a business manager account is good business practice and aids in adding to the legitimacy of your business. If you have even more questions, you can check out this section, like, why should I use Business Manager if I already have an account on Facebook? And so forth. And if you do want to go forward, click on Create Account. Then just log into your personal account with email or phone number and password and click Login. This little profile pickup here indicates that I am logged in to my personal account. Now that you're logged in, just click on Create Account again. Enter your business name, for me that's TRU LIFT Digital Marketing, and click Continue. Since you're logged in, it will pre-populate your first name and last name. Just enter your business email address and click on Finish at the bottom right. Like I said, I already have a business manager account, so I'll stop here, get into mine, and then pick things up from there. I'll just hit back and cancel to get out of this particular operation, and just go inside of my personal account by entering facebook.com in the URL field. I'll just click on the drop-down arrow on the right side of the blue navigation bar. Now in the last video, video 11, setting up social profiles, we went down here and created a business page, which is now up here, TRU LIFT Digital Marketing. What I want to do now and show you how to do is place that page inside of a business manager like I have created here. Since I already have a business manager, to show you where you will end up once you have created yours, I'll just go inside of the one that I have created for this business, autorespondersreview.com, by clicking on it. Here I am inside of my business manager account. In here, I've got an ad account for autoresponders review and my autoresponders review page. In the next few minutes, we'll set up these two accounts for you as well inside of your business manager. When you created your business manager account, you likely arrived inside of the business settings section, so I'll click on that now to load that up. Now, like I've said many times in this video series, Facebook changes the layout of their interface almost weekly, so your actual screen is likely already different than the one you see here, but by following along, you will be able to figure out how to make this work for you. I'm just going to click on this Setup Guide button at the top right so that you can see some more information on what you can accomplish inside of here and what options are available to you and how to manage those options and settings. Feel free to look around in here to give you a better sense of what is in here. I'm just going to hit the back button to go back to the business settings section. In the people section, you have your current assets. In this case, my page and ad account for this business. I don't have a product catalog assigned. If you do want to add people to your business manager to give them access to your business manager, you can do that with this button up here. We're in the people and assets section right now, which is where I spend the majority of my time when I am in here. But you also have access to various projects, partners, a payment section, business info, preferences, and requests. Feel free to look inside each of those. Then within each of those top sections, you have menu items down the side, and then hovering over the eye inside of the circle will give you information on what is contained inside of that item. The most used for me are people, pages, ad accounts, and the one we'll use in the next video to set up your Facebook retargeting, pixels. If we click inside of the pages menu items, you can see that I currently only have one page. But what I want to do is bring in my TRU LIFT digital marketing page, so I'll click on the Add New Pages button, and then since we already created that page in the last video, I want to claim that page by clicking on the first option. As it says here, to be able to claim a page, I need to be the admin, which is the highest level access, which I am, so I'll just type in my TRU LIFT page URL, which is facebook.com/TRULIFTDigital, and the search functionality pops up my page, so I'll just click on it to confirm that that is the one that I'm talking about. Check out the Facebook terms and page terms, and once you are cool with those, click on the Claim Page button. Since I'm the page admin, I get automatic approval. I'll just close that by clicking OK. Now what I want to do is create an ad account for TRU LIFT that is separate from my other ad account. But since I now have two pages here inside of the Business Manager, to be able to do that, I have to have TRU LIFT Digital as my primary page, as opposed to autorespondersreview.com, which is the primary right now. Now, if you're just starting out, the page that you just claimed will be the only page that you have, and therefore, by default, will be your primary page, so you will not have to complete this step. But just in case you end up adding more than one account, either now or in the future, I'll just quickly show you how to change the primary business page. Just click on the Business Info link in the top navigation area here. Then click on Edit on the right side. And then click the drop-down beside autoresponderswithyou.com, and I'll select TRU LIFT Digital Marketing, which automatically changed the image for me. Then I'll just change the name to TRU LIFT Digital Marketing to accurately reflect the page, and then click on Save to save the changes. Now I can create the ad account for TRU LIFT by clicking on People and Assets. I'll just click on Pages to verify that TRU LIFT is in fact now the primary page, which it is, so I'll click on Add Accounts in the side menu. And then click on Add New Ad Accounts and down to Create a New Ad Account. In this pop-up, beside Ad Account Name, I'll just call it something wildly original, like TRU LIFT Ad Account. The rest of it looks good. You can check the Facebook terms again, but otherwise click Create Ad Account. If you want to add people to that account so that they have access, you can. For me, I'll just click on Skip for now. And the ad account has been created. In order to actually use the account, you have to let Facebook know how you are going to pay for those ads, so I'll do that now to get it out of the way by clicking on the Payment Methods link. And then click on the Add Payment Method button. Fill out the relevant information and click Continue. And there you go, payment method added. Now if you are curious where you do your advertising from, or if you just want to jump right into advertising right away, I'll quickly show you that. Just go back to the People and Assets section, and then down to Ad Accounts and click on that. There are two areas of Facebook where you can create ads from. One is your Ads Manager and the other is the Power Editor. If you are just starting out, you will likely start out first using the Ads Manager. But before I click on that link, I'll just make sure I am in the correct ad account first. I'm actually in the wrong account, so I'll just switch to the one that I want, the TRU LIFT ad account, and then click on View Ad Account in Ads Manager. This is where you will create your advertising campaign, ad set, and ads. I'll go through that with you in another video. Just check out the TRU LIFT digital marketing channel if you're interested in that. And that is all we're going to cover for this video. In this video, we talked about who the Facebook Business Manager is best for and why you would want to set it up. Then we did an actual setup, or at least I went through the steps that you would take to set things up. We looked around inside the manager to see all that you have in there at your disposal. We claimed a page, which just means that we moved an existing business page inside of the Facebook Business Manager. I showed you how to create an ad account, and then I showed you where you create your Facebook ads from. Let me know if you're liking these videos that I've been putting out by clicking the like button and sharing them with your friends or fellow business owners by hitting the old share button below the video. In the last video in this How to Easily Create a Web Presence for Your Business Even If You Have Zero Technical Skills video series, we'll cover some really cool stuff that can take an okay business and put some gasoline on it by figuring out what your customers and prospects want by the actions they take using various analytics, tracking methods, and tools. And then setting you up with the ability to get back in front of those particular prospects that have already shown interest in what you are doing, but didn't go the full distance on completing an action that you hoped they would. The proverbial second chance and third chance, etc., that would otherwise just be another lost prospect. Incredibly powerful stuff, utilizing retargeting and remarketing for your website, your videos, and your ads. Video 12 is chock full of content to help move your business forward faster and round out this video series. I really hope you'll join me for the last video in this series. Keep moving your business forward, and I'll see you over there. Click the link on your screen or in the description area to go to that video now.